Hi, this is Jacob
and Francisco. We are going to talk about the 4th of July.
I'll bet you thought the 4th of July was just about the fireworks and the flag.
Well, you're wrong.
Soldiers gave up their lives to save your life. On July 4th, 1776, the 13 colonies claimed their independence from England, an event which eventually led to the formation of the United States.
The War of Independence was 241 years ago in 1776 on July 4th. It declared that the 13 states as a new nation, the USA. They were no longer part of the British Empire.
Each year on July 4th, it is also known as Independence Day. Americans celebrate this historic event.
That's all from Jacob
and Francisco. Tell us about what you think about the comments below. Bye!
Hi, this is Annalisa.
And Sierra. Today we are going to be talking about scientific facts about left-handed people.
There is a holiday all about left-handed people on August 13th. The year was 1976 when the International Left-Handed Day became produced.
Lefties also make up 12% of the population, and they use their right side of their brain.
Obama is one of the presidents that is left-handed.
Wow, this is a good one for me. They are better at multitasking.
Lefties are also called southpaws.
Left-handed people also have their own pen. Who knew?
Barack Obama, James Garfield, Herbert Hoover, Henry Truman, Gerald Ford, Ronald Reagan, George H.W. Bush, and Bill Clinton are all the left-handed presidents.
Some people are scared of left-handed people, of left-handedness. Weird. Lefties also recover from strokes faster and are most likely to pursue creative careers.
Lefties have more creative than righties. Lefties are actually rare.
Nails grow faster for southpaws and can adjust to seeing underwater faster and are good sport players.
2,500 people die being left-handed.
How is that even possible? Lefties most likely are to be on the extreme poles of the intelligence scale.
Lefties are more compatible with righties, and southpaws high five with the right hand and right high five with the left.
Lefties have good company and make friends quicker.
Even with all the facts, I still think righties are better.
I might be left-handed, but I'm always right.
Whatever. This is Annalisa
and Sierra signing out of Wallace Weekly. Bye.
Hi, this is Miguel
and Maddie,
and we are talking about Thor's new look. The first trailer of Thor has landed on March 13, 2017.
Showing off the first footage of Cady Blanchett smoldering devastatingly fierce.
Hela, aka the goddess of death.
Thor is imprisoned on the other side of the universe.
Without his mighty hammer and finds himself in a race against time.
To get back to Asgard and stop Ragnarok.
Ragnarok in Norse mythology means end of the world. This is Maddie
and Miguel,
and we are signing off from Wallace Weekly. Bye!
Hello, I'm Ella from Wallace Weekly, and I'm going to tell you about the country Japan. I'll explain first the traditional and modern music. It includes a wide array of performers and distinct styles. Here is a holograph performer, Miku Hatsune, and these are traditional performers. Japan is the second largest music market in the world behind the United States. The popular culture includes TV programs, manga, anime, and video games, all developed from older artistic and literary traditions. This anime is known as Hitalia. Each character's name is the name of a certain country, such as Italy. The candy of Japan is almost endless, just like the United States. They have a wide selection of different flavors and kinds of candy. My favorites are Meiji, strawberry, and chocolate candy, seen here. Well, I can't explain millions of years of Japanese culture, but I can encourage you to travel to Japan one day. It is a beautiful and welcoming country. This is Ella signing out from Wallace Weekly.
And Dory.
And Michaela.
And we are talking about young people who started a business.
Our first business is Sumly, created by Nick. Nick, now in his early 20s, can proudly say that a multinational corporation purchased his company and made him a millionaire. At 15, he received backing from Horizon Ventures and other angel investors to develop Sumly, a summarization app that creates summaries of news articles optimized for the iPhone. In March of 2013, Yahoo acquired Nick's company for $30 million. Nick is now studying at Oxford University in London.
The second business is Mosebooks, created by Mosiah Bridges. After being disappointed in the bow ties being unavailable to him on the market, a 9-year-old Mosiah Bridges learned how to sew his own bows with the help of his grandmother. He began selling his bow ties on Etsy, and his products were soon picked up by boutiques in several states. On top of business's success, Bridges was invited to the whole White House demo day, where he was able to personally meet President Obama and gift him with a special Obama blue nose bows.
Bridges was mentioned on Shark Tank. Mosebow's handmade bow ties, a Mammoth-based family brand business. Bridges was mentioned on Shark Tank. Mosebow's handmade bow ties, a Mammoth-based family brand business. Our very last business is Cooking with Amber Kelly by Amber Kelly. In September 2016, 13-year-old Amber Kelly was declared the winner of the television clarity competition Food Network Star Kids, which landed her a Food Network web series.
But even before the big win, Kelly had made her mark in the world of young celebrity chefs. Since 2012, she's been the star of her own healthy cooking YouTube channel called Cook with Amber.
This is Michaela.
Currently has more than 370,000 subscribers. According to her website, she was featured as a kid coach at Mashable's 2016 Kids Talk, an inspirational kid on the Today Show, Currently Wizard on the 2015 Academy Awards Live from the Red Carpet on E!
Her work has even been recognized recognized by the First Lady, Michelle Obama, at a White House dinner.
This is Dory,
Michaela,
and Cammy,
and we are signing off from Wallace Weekly. Bye!
Hello, welcome to Wallace Weekly's special edition of Inside the Mind of Students. Today we have a panel of students and they're going to talk about some topics together and give us their opinions. So today I wanted to ask you guys, there's a lot of problems going on with the United States and North Korea. There's a lot of disagreement on what North Korea is doing over there. The United States does not like how they're continuously trying to test and create nuclear missiles. And so the United States has sent some soldiers and have made some aggressive actions towards North Korea. How do you guys feel about how the United States has responded to North Korea?
I feel like if they bomb us, they're going to start World War III, so why don't we bomb them first?
I think that we should just be like, we should just apologize and say sorry. We didn't want all this stuff to happen because there's a bunch of people out there, like us kids who are innocent and we don't want this stuff to happen. So we should just apologize.
But it's gonna be harder than just saying sorry.
I agree with Eli, just like bomb them so like they don't have to bomb us first.
Disagree. I think that maybe we should just like have like a sweet conversation, a simple conversation to them to make them talk them out.
What if they don't like that? What if they disagree on us? They can bomb us, but if they bomb us, they're gonna start a whole new world, World War III.
If we bomb them, it'll make us no different.
If we talk to them about something, and if we think that they might disagree or agree, then we should have like a bomb and stuff ready just in case they say, no, I don't want this to happen. Like if they don't say yes, and we could just like go like that if they say no.
But if they bomb us, we have a lot of countries on our side because why are they bombing us? They're bombing us because we bombed Syria because they're trying to take over it and we killed thousands of kids, but we kind of started it first.
Amaya, I don't think it would make them even want to bomb us even more because it's a conversation. Nothing should we're not gonna be like aggressive like how Donald Trump is right now, like, and don't do that or we'll have other people tell you so and all that other stuff. Maybe if you just have like a conversation, a normal conversation, instead of just yelling at them.
I didn't say we're gonna yell at them. I said we should talk to them. If they say no, then we could have protection and still have our bombs ready, just in case they say no, so we know that we need to do this.
But what if we're talking and then all of a sudden one's all like, no, we're not gonna do this, we're just gonna bomb you now. What if they start bombing us? So it's better if we just bomb them first.
But even if
they bomb us, they're making it so it can go from Washington to here, like Washington DC to here. They're gonna make it 5. They're going to try to make it 5, and they've been testing out on the waters.
But like I said, if we bomb them, we're like, they're bombing us. It doesn't make us happy. If we bomb them, what do you think? They're going to be mad at us and bomb us again.
It all kind of makes us sad because you know that we're killing a bunch of kids and they're just like us. So we should just talk to them first.
I think their leader is like, just like the other person's. Syria's
Prime Minister. Yeah.
It will be like them. Like maybe he does. Maybe he's kind of like putting them, their people in danger. And just like the Syria leader, and it might like we can actually reach them. They can't. So if they threaten us, they'll get all threatened and say it like we're gonna do it now. We can bomb them before it, and it'll hurt them, and then they will get all mad and all that other stuff. Their people get mad at them.
Yeah.
So how do we change what's happening? What do we do?
I think we could just, like,
I'm gonna go down. I'm gonna ask everybody. Just give me your one sentence solution, okay, Maddie?
Just like.
How do we fix it? What do we do?
Just tell them to like stop. Cause if they don't stop, then we might start bombing them, and we don't want to kill too many people.
All right, Sarah.
Just have a simple, normal conversation to them to talk them out of it. Maybe with China.
All right.
Yeah, add China with us, and we should have a talk. But if they say no, we want to kill you guys. We don't want that. We should just have our bombs ready. And if they say no, then we could just bomb them, so we don't have any war or start anything.
All right, Cammie.
I agree with Maya.
Okay.
My thing is, if they can press the button any time, so.
But it won't reach us.
Sierra, this is his. It's just him.
It'll reach us because they're making nukes. Because even though they had a conversation that they didn't, they're not making nukes anymore. So they're doing making nukes.
We should do this. We should do the nukes right now. So when they're shooting at us, we can just shoot right back at them. So they get more hurt.
I think we should just, like, we should surrender and tell them so. Like, say, just tell them to stop and that they're gonna stop and not do it anymore.
Alright, good job, Boss Weekly.
Bye!
Let's go faster on lefties and are able to see underwater better.
Let's just.
Hi, this is Annalisa
and Sierra.
Today
we are going to be talking about left scientific facts about left-handed people.
Okay. I'm awesome. Oh my gosh.
And give to
wait,
Dad.
Can we cut?
Just.
Oh my God, Sierra.
Shut, we already.
Rose Bells.
Cut.
He was able to personally meet President Obama.
And the special Obama love Moe's bow. Bridges was.
What the heck?
Oh, restart.
And other angel investors developed.
Very last business is cooking with.
What? I'm eating that.
No, it says Dory.
Why does it say Dory on it?
What?